In this video, I'm going to be reviewing our Ecoflow Delta Pro and extra battery by shutting the power off to our home for 24 hours, mimicking a power outage. We'll be running critical loads with this setup, as well as things that aren't critical loads so you can see what it can run. Now, the battery capacity for each unit is 3,600 watt hours. That's 7,200 watt hours total, but I can't use all of that because it needs some in order to run itself. I did some testing, which you can learn more about in my channel, and I learned that it will provide about 6,600 usable watt hours. I'm calling it 6,500 watt hours. The inverter will provide 3,600 continuous running watts and 7,200 surge watts. Now, we had the transfer switch installed in our garage near the main breaker box, but I didn't want to store these out there because it's too hot in the summer, too cold in the winter, and very dusty. So I had the inlet for that transfer switch installed in the kitchen right behind the units. That way, if the power goes out, I can directly connect a cable to the transfer switch from my kitchen. I'll demonstrate that as well. Basically, we can run everything in our house from right here, except for high voltage draw things like the HVAC system or a dryer. Now, we're going to be charging the Delta Pro with three of our 100 watt solar panels. Eventually, I'll have 1600 watts worth of solar panels installed on the roof, but we're just going to deal with this for now, assuming clouds don't roll in and a storm doesn't roll in. Then later I'll demonstrate charging the Delta Pro with our dual fuel gas generator using propane. What I'll do is disconnect the Delta Pro from the transfer switch, remove the cable from the inlet in the house, and instead run this generator on a second inlet that I had installed right here outside. So we're running the house with this generator at that point. And then all the outlets in the house will have power. So all I have to do is just plug the generator, the Ecoflow, into a wall outlet to charge it. And then at the end of the 24-hour fake power outage, I'm going to demonstrate how we can charge the Delta Pro with the dryer outlet. You know, because you want to charge that thing up as soon as the power comes back on with rolling blackouts as much as you can. So I'll be pushing in about probably around 3,000 watts. So that's at the end of the video. Now, the last thing I had to figure out before a power outage is how many watt hours per hour on average is my home going to draw from these batteries? If I'm only running my refrigerator, my two freezers, and then the phantom loads from our direct wired smoke detectors and alarm system. Now, I know that the refrigerator draws 88, and both freezers would be 70, and the phantom loads about 25. So we're talking about 183 watt hours per hour on average. And if you want to learn more about how to figure that out, I've got a video series that shows you how to do that. Now, if you take 6,500 usable watt hours divided by that 183 watt hours drawn out every hour, it means that I'll be able to run this for 35 hours, that's without running anything else in my house. We're about to begin our simulated power outage. Okay, my wife just turned off the breakers and it's 12:15. We'll turn it back on tomorrow, 12:15. If we had anything that was drawing a lot of power, I'd want to turn that off before I do this. But in our case, we don't really have to worry about that. The first step is to plug in the cable to the transfer switch inlet, which I've already done, and then plug the other end to the 30 amp outlet on the Delta, and then turn the unit on. And then we're ready to go. All I have to do now is turn the transfer switch on. Okay, this is the transfer switch. Now all I need to do is turn it to generator. And we're good to go. So I turned everything off except for the refrigerator and freezers and phantom loads. So we're drawing 219, 220 watts right now. One of the nicest things about having some type of generator for when the power goes out is simply to be able to turn your lights on. You don't have to walk around with a lantern or anything, and it's just much more comfortable that way. See, with all those lights on, plus the refrigerator and freezer right now, it's taking 317 watts. Now I'm about to run something that is not a critical load, and that's my dishwasher. This is breakfast and lunch dishes. Now with my calculations, I can see that the dishwasher is going to use about 760 watt hours out of my battery. And the continuous watts will be all over the place, but the max would be 744, so that's not going to be a problem. Okay, it's 2 o'clock. Now we've been running our TV almost the entire time. The sound bar, along with cable and Wi-Fi. We ran that load of dishes. Let's find out how many watt hours we have available to use at this point. Right now, we show a state of charge of 80% on the main unit and 84 on the extra battery. Now, if I want to know, I could just add it together and divide by two, but I'm just going to always take the lower of the two. So 80% state of charge. So all I have to do is take the 6,500 usable watt hours when it's full times 0.80. 5,200 usable watt hours right now. I decided to add a fourth panel. And you can see that with four panels, four 100 watt panels right now, they're bringing in about 290 watts. Now the main unit is at a 64% state of charge and the extra battery is at 68%. I'm going to take the lower number, 64%. The available watt hours when it's full, 6,500, times 0.64. So I have about 4,000 watt hours available. I think that's plenty for me to get through the night, but let's just assume it's not. Now in this case, I would need to use my generator to charge my Delta Pro, and that's exactly what I'm going to do right now. So the first thing I need to do is disconnect my Delta Pro and extra battery from the transfer switch inlet. So I'm gonna turn everything off, power will go out of my house, and then we start up the gas generator. Okay. So I went ahead and turned off the generator at the transfer switch. Okay, so the cord's plugged in to the transfer switch outlet. I'm going to start it up. I'm going to turn the transfer switch on to generator. Okay. Look how my Delta Pro is disconnected from the transfer switch because my gas generator is using it. So now I'm going to plug the generator into the wall outlet and use the generator, the gas generator, to charge it. And there it goes. For just demonstration purposes, I'll let it run for a little while. I don't want to annoy my neighbors with my generator running. It's bringing in with 1,476 watts. 1,500. All right, I've been running the gas generator to charge the Delta Pro for 30 minutes now. We went from 64% to 74% state of charge, 76% state of charge in the extra battery. Okay, so the gas generator has been disconnected from the transfer switch, and now it's time to plug in the cable to the Delta Pro to the transfer switch. But before I do, I'm unplugging it from the wall. You don't want to run it at the same time. And there we go. 6 o'clock. So I'm making a quick little dinner here. I'm gonna heat up some mac and cheese and make a ham sandwich. I'm gonna heat this up in the microwave. The microwave uses 26
watt hours per minute.
So it's using 2200 watts, you know, along with the TV and everything else we have going right now. Okay, we're getting ready to go to bed. So I want to take a look at what we have here. 62%, 64%. So with 62%, 0.62 times 6,500 watt hours available leaves me with about 4,000 watt hours.
Okay, it's 6:40 a.m. and let's see here, we have 43% state of charge on the main unit and the extra battery is 47% state of charge. So the average, I'm still going with 43% of 6,500 watt hours. So it's about 2,800 watt hours left. It's 8:45 in the morning. So just a few hours left for our simulated power outage. My wife is going to blow dry her hair. Now the hair dryer is rated at 1550 watts, or the estimated maximum running watts, but it should only take about 110 watt hours out of the battery based on the amount of time she generally uses it. All right, my wife's gonna cook up some pancakes, bacon, and eggs on our griddle, which is rated at 1500 watts, but based on the temperature she uses, it'll be about 1350 watts. And based on the amount of time she will use it, it'll be probably around 20 minutes. We'll use about 450 watt hours out of the battery bank. Okay, it's looking pretty good. We're at 1689 watts. We're still running the freezers. The full-size refrigerator. 65-inch TV, kitchen lights, living room lights, and computer. Okay, we have about an hour and 15 minutes left of our simulated power outage, and we decided to go ahead and wash a load of clothes. The maximum running watts get up to about 1,500, but based on how we run the washer and the time frame, it'll only use about 140 watt hours. See the output watts bouncing all over the place. That's just different loads washer's putting on this. All right, we're done with the wash. The Delta Pro is at 11% state of charge. Extra battery, 13%. We're really cutting it close here. Okay, it's been 24 hours. We squeaked by. I had that planned out pretty well yesterday, I think. We had 9% state of charge and 11% state of charge. Yeah, so that worked out pretty well. So now what I'm gonna do is show you how we charge the Delta Pro and the extra battery should we be dealing with a rolling blackout. You know, they turn the power on, then they turn it off, and they turn it on, and you never know how long it might be out the next time it goes out. So we want to be able to charge our batteries here as fast as we can. And to do so, we're using high voltage from the outlet, the dryer outlet. And right here, just plug it in. Okay, so you can see it's putting in 2,800 watts. If you'd like to learn how to figure out what you can run on any portable power station and how long you can run it, basically how to manage the power in a power outage, you might want to check out my 3-part interactive video series. You can download my summary sheet here And this is a worksheet for your appliances for the summary sheet. And solar panel wiring, power outage protocol, test questions. Anyway, if it sounds interesting, go ahead and check out the link above, and I'll have links under the description below as well.
To be clear, if this were an actual power outage that we experienced, where we wouldn't know when the power would be restored and maybe limited sunlight on solar panels because of a storm, we certainly would not have run everything we ran in this video. And we would have charged our battery to 100% state of charge before going to bed, or at least as close to that as we can get it if we had the chance. Lastly, overall, I'm very impressed with the Delta Pro. One of the things I really like is how fast it charges and the variety of ways you can charge it. The inverter's large enough where I can run almost everything in my house in different combinations, except for high voltage demand like a dryer or HVAC system. It has a high battery capacity, which allows me to run those things for longer periods of time. And in my opinion, it's very efficient and very reliable. Now, there are a couple things that some people might have a problem with. One is you can't charge the extra battery independently from the Pro. You actually have to hook it up and charge it through the Pro. I don't mind, but some people might have a problem with that. And the other thing is the fan noise. I don't know if it's any louder than any other brand, and I really don't care. But if you plan on running this in the house, say every day, in order to lower your electric bill, that kind of a setup, you might consider setting it up someplace where you don't eat, sleep, or want to watch TV and that kind of thing. Well, I wanted to thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, please like it and share it, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and have a great day.